Dear students, my heartiest congratulations to all of you for your grand endeavor and success in your class 10 exam. I hope you all are safe at home in this pandemic situation due to COVID-19. The situation is not at all favorable till now for all of us, and we all are aware that it has changed a lot of our lifestyle, our living pattern, and to adjust with this situation. I welcome you all to my class. Before I start my class, I would like to discuss a few of the things of this economic syllabus for this session of 2020-21. Children, this year CBSE, due to this pandemic situation, has reduced the syllabus up to 30%, and we all are aware of that. Now, before I start my class, I would like to discuss a few points of this deleted syllabus which will help you regarding your studies, and you will be knowing better what to study and what not. Dear children, before I start my virtual class, I would like to show you the marks distribution of the CBSE Class 11 Economics syllabus. In front of you, you can see there is Part A, that is Statistics for Economics. You have the introduction chapter. Then you have the next chapter, that is Collection, Organization and Presentation of Data, which is carrying 13 marks, and the next chapter is Statistical Tools and Interpretation, which will be carrying 27 marks. This all three parts constitute total of 40 marks. Now this whole portion is the statistics portion for the entire year. Now let us come to the Part B. Part B, you have Introductory Microeconomics. The introduction chapter carries 4 marks. Consumer Equilibrium and Demand carries 13 marks. Producer Behavior and Supply, it is also carrying 13 marks. And at the end, conclusion of this chapter, we have the Forms of Market and Price Determination. And at the concluding part of the introductory microeconomics, we have Forms of Market and Price Determination under Perfect Competition with Simple Applications, which is carrying 10 marks. So all these four parts of Part B constitute 40 marks. So Part A and Part B constitutes total of 80 marks. And Part C, you have the project work of 20 marks, which will be divided into two parts for summative assessment 1 and summative assessment 2. So that will be carrying 20 marks. With this, we have the total of 100 marks distribution. Now, let me discuss and tell you the deleted topics which this time CBSE has deleted for the coming session 2021. Please note down that in Part A, it has not deleted actually any chapter, but from the entire chapter, it has deleted a few of the topics. See, if the entire chapter was deleted, it would have been a different issue. Why? Because you had have a no idea of what to study and what not. But as CBSE has deleted a few of the topics from the chapter, so if possible, I would suggest you that you please at least go through the chapters if possible, and if time permits, I will also let my entire effort to at least give you a brief description or a brief introduction of the topics that have been deleted. Why? Because deleted portions are as well as very important, because you have to study these topics in your higher classes or in your upcoming classes, and so you should have a brief knowledge of it. Now, let me discuss the deleted topics which CBSE has deleted for this session. Part A, you can see that statistics for economics, the topics deleted are from Unit 3, that is statistical tools and interpretation. The topics which have been deleted are range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, and coefficient of range, coefficient of quartile deviation, coefficient of mean deviation. And there is one more chapter, that is correlation. Spearman's rank correlation have been deleted. In the same unit, you have another chapter, that is index number, index of industrial production. This entire topic has been deleted. These two chapters, that is correlation and index numbers, these were very easy chapters and very scoring also. But unfortunately, this time, these two topics have been deleted. Now, before that, I proceed to the introductory microeconomics. I would like to tell you that if you get the time, or if I get the time, I would like to give a brief introduction of these topics so that it would be easier for you to understand for your coming classes. Now, let me come to the part B, that is introductory microeconomics. Here also, none of the entire chapter has been deleted by CBSE, but what it has done is that it has deleted a few of the topics from the chapters. So the chapter you have to continue to study, only some of the topics we will not continue this year. So you can see in Unit 4 introduction, the concept of production possibility frontier, this topic has been deleted. Now we have in Unit 6 producer behavior and supply, wherein producers equilibrium meaning and its condition in terms of marginal revenue, marginal cost, this entire topic has been deleted from Unit 6 portion. Now let us come to the concluding part, that is Unit 7, which is forms of market and price determination under perfect competition with simple applications. This is the last chapter of the introductory microeconomics. Here in this portion, only the perfect competition has been taken into account, and all other market forms, that is monopoly, monopolistic competition, their meaning and features, this entire topics have been deleted. Now, if you don't have the books, please get with your books. I have already mentioned and I have already sent the pick of the books. All of you have to buy NCERT books. If you don't have the option to get a new one, you can continue to manage from your senior ones or the old books of NCERT, or you can also download the PDF of NCERT. Apart from NCERT, you need to get two more books, than one for statistics and another for microeconomics. So the books which I have already told you, in the coming classes, we will start first with the statistical part. I'll start with the statistics, and you have already done, I hope, and you remember mean, median, mode. So please revise those topics because the time is too less and the chapters are very huge. Syllabus is absolutely too huge and big, and we have to cover up a lot of things in this quite a short period of time. So I request all of you, please go through the mean, median and mode chapters. I'll be starting first with mean, median and mode, and then I will start with the theoretical part, because practical portions are much more than the theoretical part. So I need to cover up the practical portions first, then I will continue with the theoretical portions. So till now, a big thanks to you all, and I heartily welcome again to my class to all the students of commerce and humanities, because I'll be taking up both the commerce and the humanities. So I welcome you all again.